Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this video will help you save time in Google Drive. There are so many great Google Drive features that they can't all fit into one video. We'd be here all day. So I've got some other videos linked below on some of the best Google Drive features. And if you love Drive as much as I do, you'll want to check those out and also make sure you are subscribed to my channel. Okay, let's dive back into Drive. So if you're new to Google Drive and you're looking for a tutorial on how to use Google Drive, I have a video on all of that and more, and I've linked to it in the description below. But be sure to watch all the videos I've linked below if you want to become a Google Drive power user. Okay, enough blabbing. Let's get into some of my picks for the must-know Google Drive tips. And first, I want to start with something that's probably my favorite, and that is to convert images to text. So here's what I mean. I've taken this screenshot of a cookie recipe. Actually, it's a really good cookie recipe, by the way. But while I can comment on this image, see if I click, I can add a comment. I can't actually grab the text to copy and paste it over into a doc. And I don't want to waste time and rewrite out this recipe from scratch. I just want to use the text that I see in this picture. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to close out of this full screen preview. And now I'm going to right click on the image and select open with Google Docs. So this opens a brand new Google Docs tab, and you'll have the image file at the top of the doc. But scroll down below that, and oh, hello, would you look at that? All the text from the image is right here in an editable format. How cool is that? This time-saving trick will work with any image that has text, because Google is using optical character recognition, or OCR technology. Okay, next up. Did you know that you can create a new file from any tab while searching the web? It's true. So let's say you're easily distracted like me, or you're just browsing the web and you come across something that reminds you, you have to do that document that you're supposed to be working on. So you can just head up here to your browser bar and then type in doc.new, hit enter, and blammo whammo, a brand new doc is instantly opened for you in that tab. By the way, this works with sheets and slides and forms too. So for sheets, you'd type in sheets.new into the browser bar, or deck.new for a new slide deck, or forms.new for a new Google form. Talk about a time saver. Wowza. This next tip is more of an organizational time saver tip for Google Drive, and that's to color code your Google Drive folders. So think like if you were calendar blocking in your Gcal, except you can give color codes to these folders too in Drive. So first, here is an example of my calendar. Now, I have specific clients blocked off with certain colors, but you could organize it any way you want. So this way, from one glance, I can easily tell what's what. So why not do the same over here in Google Drive? So back in Drive, it all kinds of blends together with this default gray folder color here. So let's change that by selecting the folder we want to change, and we'll right click on that folder and select color. Then just select the color that you want, and voila, the folder color is changed and it gives you that quick visual cue. Fourth on the list of must-know Google Drive tips is to use the Explore tool. Now, I don't mean to just explore and search within Drive. I mean to search within Drive, to search the web, like the entire web, and to do an image search on the web, all from your file in Drive. So when you're working in a file, like I am here in this doc, there's this symbol in the bottom right corner of the file. This is the Explore feature. So click on Explore and a tab will open up on the right-hand side of your screen. Now at the top here, you can enter in a search term for something you're trying to find. So let's say I'm writing about Google Drive, so I want to find related Google Drive content here. I'll type in Google Drive in the search field, and now look at this. here we have web results, image results, and drive results. So under web here, you have all kinds of web search results, and cooler yet, if you hover over them, you actually have the option to cite that web result in a footnote, all without leaving Drive. Now click on images, and from here, you can simply drag and drop your image right into your file. Such a time saver, but wait, there's more. Click on Drive in your Explore tab, and any files you've created that contain that search term will be brought up right here. It's easy as that. This next tip to save time in Google Drive is to find and insert links into the file you're working with without leaving Drive itself. Yeah, you can do that too. So, you may already know how to highlight or right-click on a word or phrase to hyperlink it. But there's some cool features in here that will actually allow you to do so without leaving the doc to go find the link you want to put in. So using a website as an example here, I'm going to highlight and right click and select link. Right here in the results is their website. I don't even have to leave my doc to go to their site and copy and paste this back into my doc. Now, don't worry if the exact site doesn't come up, because there's actually a way to get to it right from here too. So this time, for this example, I'll just go ahead and use my name here. And once again, I'm gonna highlight and right click, and let's see what comes up. Okay, so my Instagram comes up in the suggestions, but I wanna link this to my website. So in this link box right here, I'm gonna type in my website, which is my name. And look, now I can link directly to my site from here. And now we've come to our final tip before a bonus one at the end. And this is tip number 6. And it's to use the voice typing feature to dictate your message directly to Drive. So if you are a slow typer, you definitely want to take advantage of this feature. From your file, place your cursor wherever you want to start the dictation. And now head on up to Tools and select Voice Typing. So here on the left, you can adjust the language if necessary. And then when you're ready to dictate, click the microphone and just start speaking. Everything I'm saying is being typed in my doc in real time, much quicker than I could manually type it. So as promised, here is a bonus tip for you. We just talked about how you can change the language if you're using the voice typing tool in Drive. Well, you can also translate an entire file. So back in your tools, just select Translate Document. This is very helpful if you're collaborating with teams across the world. Well, that's how to save time in Google Drive. What do you think of some of my must-know Google Drive tips? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for those other Google Drive videos. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.